let's stand up and let's get our hands moving. Come on, everyone. Let's go. Let's get our feet in gear. It's time to welcome for the first time, Mr. Adam.
Thank you.
to Mr. Albert Simon, the grandfather of the Kala, who will initiate the Seudat Mitzvah with Hamotzi. Amen.
I don't think there's enough enthusiasm here tonight. I really am kind of let down that it's so quiet and people are not showing their true feelings for Shipra and Donnie. I really wish
they could just get over your inhibition.
I really wish people would try to have a good time here instead of, you know, being so kind of lazy and tired and stuff. But we'll see what happens. The night's early. And maybe if they eat a little bit, they get a little energy, and maybe they can kind of get up off their seat and dance a little bit. Drinks.
Mazel tov and l'chaim.
Mazel tov, Shipra and Donnie.
Mazel tov.
Mazel tov.
Mazel tov.
Mazel tov.
Mazel tov and bracha.
Not allowed to speak.
Mazel tov.
Mazel tov. Mazel tov.
Mazel tov. Mazel tov.
Mazel tov.
Mazel tov. Mazel tov.
Mazel tov and l'chaim.
Mazel tov.
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 Mazel tov. Don't slow down and don't.
Mazel tov to Shifra and Donnie. I'm so happy for both of you. She live a long, healthy, and happy life.
Father of our Chatan, Dr. Yerachmiel Wellman, please give her your kindest attention.
Thank you, Ben.
Please get right into it.
Don't get nervous. There's only two little speeches. I really have to thank Milton and Esther Simon for producing a perfect match for Donnie. They have six wonderful girls and the sweetest little boy around. And on their first try, they have six wonderful daughters and the sweetest little boy around. And on their first try, right off the bat, Shifra, made to order, just what Donnie needed. Shifra is smart and spunky, not to mention beautiful, and deeply committed to keeping the Torah. Debbie and I also have to thank the Simon family for being so organized and ambitious in planning the wedding party. It's been great fun working with them and getting to know them. Equally organized and ambitious is my wife, Debbie. Many thanks to her. And thanks to our dear children. Of course, all this would not have been possible without Bracha and Eitan Cashman, who did the matchmaking. Good job. We want to thank all our friends from LA and from Long Beach for coming to celebrate with us. Thanks also to Donnie's friends from Yeshiva University for flying in from New York to gladden the hearts of the Chassan and Kala. Thank you to the rabbis whose presence graces this simcha, and especially to the Masader Kedushin, Rabbi Meir Pogro, from Israel. Warm thanks to Donnie's uncles and cousins from Toronto and Muncie, and to his boogie Lily and great aunt Dorothy, and she is great, from Toronto. Thanks to all our dear relatives and friends who came here from near and far to be with us at our time of great happiness. On this joyous occasion, we find ourselves in the week of the Torah portion, Bishalach. This parsha details our deliverance from the Egyptian bondage and our new national life in the most unlikely of settings, the desert wilderness, the Midbar. The wilderness is a place where an entire nation cannot possibly expect to find sustenance and protection. Yet it was into that most inhospitable place that our newborn nation followed God in those earliest days of our relationship with Him. Centuries later, in God's name, the prophet Yirmiyahu said to Israel, Zacharti lach tesed uraich habastu losayich lachtech acharai b'mibar be'eretz lo zruah. I remember the affection of your youth, your loving devotion at our wedding, when you followed me into the wilderness, into a land that was not sown. Right at the beginning of our free national existence, Hashem justified our fresh, pure faith in Him by providing for us. Miraculously, He fed us with His manna, quenched our thirst with the water of the well of Miriam, and protected us with His clouds of glory. And what He asked from us in return was to remain faithful to Him by leading the pure Jewish lifestyle that He would teach us. If Israel would have remained faithful to her mission, the whole world would have watched admiringly as we blossomed into a happy model society in the land of Israel. By the good example of God's firstborn, Israel, all the nations would have gladly come to learn to fulfill their own duties, and the goal of humanity could have already been reached. But as Israel prospered, our nation often turned its back on God's Torah. That possibility was clearly anticipated. The Torah warned us that we might have to be exiled from our land, but it promises that no matter what, God will mold us into the holy nation we are destined to be. Throughout history, we had the opportunity to return to the Torah and end our suffering in exile, but there is a limit how long the exile will last. In the end, God will arrange events so that we will once again find ourselves in the Midbar, in the wilderness, as a test and opportunity for us to demonstrate our love and trust in Him. In Hosea, it states, Lachem hine anochi mefateha v'holachtiha hamibar v'dibarti aliba v'natati la et kerameha misham v'et ena kachor l'fetach tikva v'anasa shama kimeni ureha v'kayom alosam yeretz Mitzrayim. Therefore, says God, I will tempt her and lead her into the wilderness. I will soothe her and give her back her vineyards. I will turn the depths of sorrow and confusion into a gate of hope. And she will respond to me there as she did in the days of her youth, as she did on the day that she went up out of the land of Egypt. Our generation bears witness to the rejuvenation and flourishing of the land of Israel, the returning remnant of Israel. We have seen the depths of sorrow and confusion of the Holocaust turn into a gate of hope in the reestablishment of Jewish sovereignty in Eretz Yisrael. Please don't talk. Yechezkel prophesied, V'hotzeiti etchem min ha'amim, v'yad chazaka v'zro'a netuya v'chema shpucha I will bring you out of the nations with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, and with fury poured forth. And then I will bring you into the wilderness of the nations. We are now indeed in the midst of the wilderness of the nations. Israel becomes increasingly marginalized by a hostile United Nations. That same Europe, who 60 years ago perpetrated the most cruel, systematic slaughter of our people, now brazenly presumes to criticize our efforts. They denounce our supposed mistreatment of the Arab element within us, clearly committed to another slaughter of the Jews. But, acharis kivareshis, God will again entice us to believe in him. He has already assured us that we can bring the redemption swiftly, gloriously, and painlessly, if only we would be ready to once again follow him into the desolate and dangerous desert with no power there to help us except God himself. If only we would be ready to stand firm in carrying out what our Torah calls for without fear of how the Gentile nations might react. The prophet Hosea reassures us with words of consolation and hope. Ve'erastich lilolam, ve'erastich li b'tzedek mishpat v'chesed v'rachamim, ve'erastich li b'emunah b'yadat es Hashem. I will betroth you to me forever. I will betroth you to me in righteousness and in justice and kindness and in mercy. And I will.
Is a ray of light. Donnie Weltman, just as his voice is pure and clear, so is his neshama pure and clear. And that's why I can truly say that I'm extremely happy tonight that he is the husband of my daughter Shifra, and may they both be happy and live long in Eretz Yisroel, and may we all join them there soon.
I'm dedicating this song to my mother and my father for their 22 years of hard work, and it really paid off. So, and this is also dedicated to Mr. and Mrs. Simon, mom and dad, or sir, and sir dad, and I know they did a great job with Shifra, so it's also for them. Here we go. Okay.
Okay.
everybody. What we're going to do now is we're going to bench and say the Sheva Brachas so that everybody gets a chance in participating in that mitzvah. Afterwards, we hope that those who can will stay as we have more dancing and dessert. But I'm asking all of you, especially the women, please stop talking now. Have a seat, because the benching is going to happen now.
Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Shehakol Bara Lichvodo.
Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Yotzer Adam.
Amen.
Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Yotzer Zondo Mitzaloi Vitzelem Demut Pachisoi. Is killing the man of the yard of the yard, but if I don't know, you take it all. So,
Tossies, the Soviet Hakara, the Kibbutz Banana, the Sofa, the Sinha, Borough of the Noah, the Sunday of Zion, the Vadeva. Sameach to Samafrim Harim, Kisaleh to Sayyidzir, for the Ganeidim, we can't let Baruch Ato Adinoi, Kisaleh to Sayyidzir, for the
Baruch Ato Adinoi, Eloheinu Melech Olam, Asher Baras, Asam, Nisimcha, Chasam, Rechala. Ilarina ditzavichedva, avol yachva, v'shalom nereyos. Adonai Eloheinu Shamam, yarei Yehuda, v'chutzos Yerushalayim. Kol sasan, v'kol simcha. Kol chasan, v'kol kala. Kol mitzalos chasanin, michupasam. Uniarim, yinishtei, niginasam. Baruch ato Adonai, nisameach chasan, im hakala.
Baruch ato Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, voidei pri Yaakov.
really hope to be here for some of her sister's weddings. And mazel tov, she's a very lucky lady. She got a wonderful husband and a wonderful family. Thank you so much.
gonna tell you something, that this music is the best I've heard. That Shimon and Aaron and Nachum band is the best band, and the best solo singer is Donnie Weltman. I think he's gonna get a prize for singing at this wedding tonight. And most of all, for the Ruach, and for the love, and for all of the energy and excitement of all of his friends and all of Shifra's friends. This energy and this Ruach and this happiness is going to bring Mashiach now. Talk to Shifra, loud.
I'll tell you something. You know, when I was dancing with you, you grabbed me, and you told me, Anki Ratch, you're the best Anki Ratch I've ever had. I'm so glad about that. And you're the best Donnie and Shifra that I've ever had, and ever will have, probably. So I love you both, and I want to wish you mazel, hatzlacha, baracha. All things good, and all things that are good for you. For the rest of your life, you should bring a lot of nachas to your parents, your entire family, your aunties and uncles, and aunties and aunts, and all the love is wrong. And I love you. Mazel tov.
Shifra and Donnie, I really had a great time at your chasan. I wish you the best. Lots of mazel and hatzlacha. I'm proud of you both.
First of all, I want to thank my parents and Shifra's parents for making this whole thing. It was wonderful, and they worked so hard, sleepless nights, and almost sleepless nights, and so much stress and everything. Thank you so much for what you've done, and for raising us. Thank you so much. You did a great job, and you'll continue to do great jobs with the rest of your kids. You better. And to everybody who came to the wedding, thank you so much for coming. It was beautiful. It was only beautiful because so many people were here and danced like crazy. A lot of fun, and we had so much fun. Thank you so much.